This all came to be. Do you know why they call me mad? Do you know why I'm so maniacal? Oh, let me tell you a story about fame and glory and about the dead. And they come back and they walk, they breathe again when they shouldn't. I said it was impossible. He said it was impossible. Right, he was right, it was impossible. Without the help of some syringes, without the help of just modern science. Our story starts in a house inside my mind where death, graceful, wonderful death, looms over us all. So I hope you're ready. Sit tight, don't budge, don't blink. Just think of the illusion of the dead corpsing over you like a dead beating dog. You know what? I'm gonna go pay a visit to old Herb.
Herbed? Herb, I'm backing down, man.
What?
Whoa!
Yes, sir. Name? Do you know my name? You one of them Satanists?
No. Hey, Herbed, it's me. Mark.
Oh! Mark! It's been so long since I've seen you, I almost didn't recognize you. So, how you been? You finally the legal age to drink? Haha, I'm just kidding. You know it hasn't stopped me in the past. Go on, have a seat.
Well, slow day, huh?
It's 9:15 on Wednesday, Mark. Say, you want some of my homemade brew?
What?
It's a little thick, so it takes a while to pour.
Yeah.
Whatever. You're not supposed to consume it in large amounts anyway. That's what accidentally killed my ex-wife. You know, I'm so proud of the collection of beers I have imported over the years. You enjoy your brew?
Oh, yeah.
Ah, thanks. Say, Mark, I'm finally starting to crack down on those damn shakers that run this town.
Yeah, you know what? You've been saying that for years, Herman. I mean, what's stopping you from getting them?
Well, I've got to figure out their method of attacks first. And once I do, I'm going to finally expose them damn Satanists. And I'm going to get rich enough to pay my taxes.
You know, I really wouldn't count on that, Herman.
But it's true, Mark. My cousin Earl, he had evidence of the Satanists. Some strange program on TV named SpongeBob. He found satanic propaganda promoted to our children in it. A couple months later, his trailer blows up. The police said it was the meth lab, but I know my cousin Earl, and I know he was far too good at cooking meth to have a slip-up like that.
Attention everyone! This my dude's life is on the line!
I lost him!
Why, Cromwell? Why must you take such an innocent being? Mark Grayson, how you been, my man?
You know this guy, or is this just another, crackhead coming in?
We were, acquaintances in high school.
Yeah, so, you got a job yet?
No.
Oh, well, I'm a med student, you know? Studying to save people's lives.
Perfect.
Which, actually, I'll get back to.
Sam.
What an arrogant scumbag. I think he just came into here to gloat.
Tell me about that guy. He's a loser.
What did you say about me, Mark?
I said you were the nicest person in the world. You should eat ice cream every day. Well, I mean, he's a med student. I can't compete with that. All right, talk to you later. Just an illusion from the concussion. All right, what is this?
Shag. Go into the shag.
Should I? Alright, fine.
On Mark, you don't recognize your own father?
No. My father's been dead for months, and he's got some brain in a jar.
Oh yeah, sorry about that. I kinda had to fake my own death.
Why your brain?
Well, my old body was getting weak, so I changed it. Just think of it like, changing a pair of clothes, because maybe your previous pair was covered in blood.
No, this is from... This is a blizzard from the concussion. I need to get out of here.
Did that feel like a delusion?
What do you want from me?
Oh, Mark, you're very important to me.
How?
You see, Mark, when you were born, I saw your beautiful little baby boy face. I realized how wonderful life truly was. Thus, I started doing research into stopping the one thing that destroys life. Death!
That's impossible!
I once thought that way too, but then I did it! Go check out those needles over there.
I'm not gonna do it.
Yeah. Okay, alright, I'll do it.
Say, get one of the fingers out of the jar and use the needle on it. Ugh.
Oh. Oh. Oh.
It still has little kinks to work out, but that's where you come in, Mark. I need you. Mankind needs you.
I'm not smart enough to secure death.
Well, Mark, what about that med student rival of yours? I mean, you want to compete with him, right?
How the hell do you know?
I have my ways.
This whole thing sounds... Okay, I'll do it.
Well, that's good. Now you'll just have to kill.
What?
I mean, for the experiment, we're gonna need a couple bodies.
Can we just, like, rob graves or something?
No, I've tried. They're not nearly fresh enough.
I'll just stop doing that.
That's great.
Let me sleep on that, alright?
Well, good night, son. I love you.
Hey, Marky.
Oh, God.
So, you know, I just wanted to say sorry for, you know, bragging about how much better I am than you and, you know, all that. So, you don't remember when in high school when, you know, I beat you up and kind of dropped this thing?
Yeah, fun times.
Well, I kept it all this time. And now I'm giving it back to you.
How generous.
Well, I gotta get going, you know, saving lives and all that, but... if you ever want to, you know, come over, I actually just live right across the street, you know?
Okay, get out.
Never, ever send your boy to therapy. They give him all these new ideas. They say, oh, your dad's abusive. Oh, your dad's neglecting. Your dad's an alcoholic. Those are false. And then, you know, he does go to live with your mother in a big, liberal city like California or Canada. It's unbelievable. Oh! Hey, Mark, how do you do over there?
Jimmy came to my house.
How do you find your address?
I
didn't know. Oh! Leo, how you doing, my man?
Oh, hey, Mark. Let me tell you, business is booming. Even though we have to, you know, cut the budget and downgrade the whatever these are.
Wait. You have a business?
Oh, I run a business. We cut trees and stuff. We are 99% accident-free.
What'd you say?
So wait, you're gonna kill this guy on accident?
Yeah, I'm gonna call him up. Then I'm going to lead him down to cut the tree branch, then distract him. It's a ethical way of killing people.
I really think it'd be a better choice for you to just directly kill him.
I'm not killing anyone, Dad.
Ooh, you called me Dad!
It was an accident, alright?
science. He's an innocent guy, alright?
Oh, son, I remember my first time having to kill somebody. It was hard at first, but as I slammed that chair into that innocent woman's head and felt each little bit of her skull fragments tear apart, it felt like years of stress and anxiety were lifted off of me.
You're an hinge, man!
Is that something someone who's unhinged would do?
Yeah.
Oh, well, anyway, son, go out and kill that guy. Or I'll kill him! For the good of mankind.
Hey!
Where's the, log?
It's, right over there.
Are you sure you're gonna need me for this?
Listen, I'm paying you extra here, right?
Alright. Hey! Dude! How'd you do that? Hey! Oh, stop! You gotta give me my second circumcision, you son of a bitch! My hand! My hand! Oh, my precious little hand!
Well, certainly a mess. How are you doing?
So, Mr. Grayson. Okay, Mark, what exactly happened here?
Well, this guy came over here and he was sawing off a tree branch and he got distracted and cut his own hand off. I tried to help him, but he kind of ran off.
Listen here, man. You see this glove? It means nothing to me. You know, back in the summer of 74, there was this kid, it was his birthday party, and his uncle decided to chop some wood with his chainsaw. Little did he know, it went horribly wrong.
Those party poppers went off at the wrong time. And the uncle got so startled that he threw the chainsaw. And the clown's face turned blood red.
Just when I thought it couldn't get any worse, the clown's arm flew across the party, smacking the kid right in his eyes. He has to wear prescription sunglasses now. And then, to make matters even worse, a military veteran came into the party and informed the kid his dad died in Nam! I'm not a religious man, but I told that kid, this has to be the work of Satan.
Man, that kid must have been screwed up for life.
Nah, I think he's fine. I think he owns a bar. What's his name? Oh yeah, it's Herman.
Hey, can I have those back? Please?
I can't believe I killed somebody! The money's off my bar!
Oh, there, son. I mean, it probably wasn't that bad after all.
No, it was bad.
Okay. It felt awesome. It felt great.
All right then. Now let's get working on this stuff.
It's done, but now we need something to test it with.
Well, Mark, looks like you're gonna have to kill somebody again.
What?! How many more innocent people do I have to indirectly kill?!
And just do it directly!
Now, I don't want to do it directly! That's wrong! Okay, alright. You know what? I'll just get on it.
Hey everybody, Cliff Dinkins Jr. here, owner and operator of Kong's, where we've been providing top quality meat to Heapersville, Indiana residents for 50 years. My great-grandfather retired from big game hunting and opened Kong's restaurant, where we've been providing top quality meats to Heapersville, Indiana for 50 years. Now, pretty soon, my grandson, Carl Jenkins Jr. Jr., will be running the show. Say hello, Carl Jr. Jr.
Hi.
Now, why don't you tell them what we serve here, Carl?
We serve chicken,
chops? Ish.
Now you come on down to Kong's and see us.
Now the key to our secret ingredient is our special meat.
Sir, my name's Richard Head. Now, does your wife happen to be home?
I'm not married.
Oh, well, is your mother home?
I live alone.
Well, okay. Say, are you interested in buying knives? Now, that knife there is top of the line, made with the finest materials.
Seems kind of cheap to me.
No, sir, I assure you, that is the most top-of-the-line, finest-grade aluminum that you can find in this world.
Say, Richard, you go around here?
Well, that's an awfully funny question.
Just answer your question.
Well, if you must insist, no, sir, I'm from the great state of Texas.
Guess it was pretty cheap after all. Sure this is gonna work?
Just believe in yourself, son. I'm sure you did great.
For your stuff again. I'm gonna file a full police report on this incident, you know.
This is just one accident. Even the greatest scientists sometimes have accidents. Maybe you could just use a helping hand around the lab. Would you happen to know anybody who'd be willing to do that, though?
Oh! Hey, Mark!
Hey, how's it going? I just wanted to apologize for, being so weird lately, so, I bought some wine.
Okay, well, let me pour you a drink. So, you see the game last night? You know, the final touchdown in the last few seconds, that was pretty awesome.
Yeah.
What a throw, I mean, all the way up there. Oh, hey, what's that? What the hell? Where am I?
Oh, I knew you shouldn't have gotten someone who's such a wimp.
Don't worry, Dad. It won't be in a moment.
Hello, Timmy.
Welcome to our humble little home.
Are you gonna kill me?
No. We aren't gonna kill you, silly. We need you.
Need me? For what?
Well, you see, me and my dad over here are making this little miracle drug that can bring people back from the dead.
That's absurd!
No, you listen here!
You can help us.
Okay, well, where do we start?
Well, we were making a little prototype in the beginning, but that goes exactly as planned. So, notes on what we've been doing, and thus as
did you hear, Diary? My love for... Mark, this is incomprehensible nonsense. You have to use proper medical terms, like what's red skish and ZMB44.
I told you you were bad at science, son.
You did not!
I mean, do you even have the proper organs for this?
Of course I do. Here you go.
Oh god, what the? Well, I mean, there are a few tools that, you know, I could use. You could probably find them at the local pharmacy. I mean, here.
Mark, while you're out, go ahead and stop by this restaurant called Kong's and ask for the special. The parts they provide you with shall be essential to our experiments.
Oh, Mark, where have you been?
What?
You've been missing for 3 days. You haven't answered a single one of my calls. What's with the lab coat?
I've been doing a little, business inside my, shed.
Okay.
Derek, I gotta go, get some, shopping done, so... Hey, are you, Cliff from Kong's?
Yeah?
Could I, get the, special?
Not with the feds, are you?
No.
Okay.
Junior!
Here is your stuff.
Oh my!
So tired right now, Dad.
Well then, son, you ought to rest. Take the day off. But remember, tomorrow you're gonna have to kill again.
Okay, please don't do that again.
Well, Mark, I'll see you tomorrow then.
Don't you think you're being a little cruel to that little boy?
A little cruel? Are you kidding me? I'm incredibly cruel to Mark!
I need some of that Garrett's original.
I just saw Mark.
Oh, really? What's going on with him?
I don't know, but he's been acting strangely lately.
How so?
Just not like his normal self. He's been talking about a shed? Thing
huh. Back? Well, he could always be possessed by a Satanist. Oh my god, that's terrible!
Good morning, Jumbo.
This is what I've stayed up all night creating. Biomort 0.6. It's a great improvement on your previous.
Here, can we please just see the stuff in action?
Had a heart attack. All this work for nothing. Now I have to make a new formula.
Well, you know, sorry, man. I wish I could, help you. But I got
why did you do that?
You gotta help Jimmy.
I thought you said I was bad at science.
I never said that!
They lied to you!
What was I saying again?
How you were about to help Jimmy work on Biomorph 0.7.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, because I'm great at science, yeah.
Wow. You know what, Jimmy? That was probably the best montage I was ever in.
Yeah, man. That was surprisingly fun. I wish we could have kept those memories. Wish we would have filmed it.
Ah, never mind. Let's go get some calls.
Say, Jimmy, will you turn your head around a bit? I've got something I have to show you.
Sorry, Jimbo, I couldn't get the car. Just outside, and I got arrested, and I have no idea. Hey there.
You alright?
Oh. Hey, do you know what this thing is? Jimmy!
What are you doing?
You didn't need him anymore, Mark. You two completed the experiment.
Wait, but I thought you said there was no reason to kill anymore. This is a cure for death, not like a, you know.
Man, I'm gonna be honest with you. This stuff's not gonna be used for good. It's gonna be used to take over the world.
What?
Look at the upside. If you're in control, no one's ever gonna push you around again. Though we are gonna need a bigger undead army, so you're gonna have to kill a couple more of your friends.
No way. I'm helping you, you psychomaniac.
Snap back into
it. It's time.
Time to go make some phone calls.
You see, when an alien probes a man, he takes his little finger, not quite much bigger than my pinky, and he slowly begins to move it towards you.
Hold on, man. What the hell? Mark, what's up?
Huh?
What?
Mark,
what's
wrong?
Huh? We have to go.
Whoa. Hey.
Go check outside. I'm checking in.
All right. Gotta make sure Satan's
talking.
I forgot his name.
What's up with the arm, Dad?
Oh, it's nothing. It's just, you know, a little thing that I made for... What is that?
Oh, my God! Mark is a Satanist! No! Please! Please don't do this! I'm disavowed God! Please! Oh, Mark! You... monster! You vaccinated me! Oh God! What's that thing gonna do to me?
No clue. Never tested on somebody's liver.
Well, that ain't good. Oh my God! Mark's a killer.
Oh, Derek! Oh, Derek! Come out wherever you are!
I'd like to make a toast.
Men, tonight is the night where we rise up and take over this town!
What do you want with me?
Hello.
See, officer, we want something simple. We want something unique. We want the town.
I own the town.
Mark, you told me that he owned the town. Son, would you come over here? I have something I need you to do. Say, just, put your head inside this little bowl on my arm. You too, officer. Come here. Come right here. Come here. I'm gonna be honest with you, son! I wasn't honest with you even when I said I was being honest with you! I'm going to steal your body and transfer my brain into it! That's right! You are just a profit by scheme! And soon, I'll be living as you!
Oh, finally! It's Blueberry Burst!
Much for listening to my wonderful story. You didn't blink, you didn't move, you didn't drink, you didn't even stutter when you asked a question. Oh, that's hilarious. Oh.